Hi everyone, welcome back, and today I'm so excited to be interviewing a part of New Zealand food culture that is very popular and is a must interview on this whole tourism journey and platform. I don't know if you can guess, but maybe take a guess from my background. Let's do some setting of the scene. This is a dish that was brought into New Zealand by the British in the 1900s. It is a very staple Kiwi dish and a very popular takeaway food. It's the classic fish and chips of New Zealand. So for those of you who don't know, fish and chips is battered deep fried fish, usually served with chips. And today I'm very grateful to be interviewing Raglan Fish right here in the town of Raglan. These guys on TripAdvisor, they were rated top, one of the best fish and chip shops to visit in the Waikato region. So, and personally, this is one of my favorites here. I always come here with my family in the summertime, and it's giving summer vibes today. So, yeah, without further ado, let's get straight into it. So welcome to the team at Raglan Fish.
And Mark. Hi.
Thanks, Mark.
Amazing.
Oh, awesome. Thank you so much, guys, for being here. We got the owner and the manager here. A little bit of the history of Raglan Fish.
Raglan Fish was established 10 years ago after the fire. We had a major fire on this building, which was rebuilt, which was 13 years ago, the fire, and it took 3 years to rebuild. We've been operating for 10 years. Maisie's been a loyal colleague. She's been here more than 6 or 7 years on and off.
So
she knows how to prepare the food at its best.
Yeah. What sort of fish do you use here at Raglan Fish?
Right, so we do the gurnet, snapper, and the flounder.
Yeah. Like, what would you say is a most popular thing ordered here? Popular fish.
Popular fish is the gurnet.
Number one gurnet. One of the cool things about Raglan Fish is earlier, what you might have seen is where they're actually right very close to the wharf. Do you have any specials or different dishes you do at certain times of the year?
Yeah, let's say for example a white bait fritter.
Yeah.
So white bait, it's now in season.
Yeah.
But it's nearly finished, like in another 2 weeks time.
Oh, okay.
So white bait fritter is the best.
Yeah. Thank you.
We also in December have a lot of tuna boats. Tuna. Yeah. White flesh tuna.
White flesh tuna.
So it's nice to have it here. It's a seasonal fish. Okay. We do get the odd red flesh tuna.
Red flesh. Is that more rare?
Yeah, the yellowfin and the big eye. We see a few fish come in with the tuna vessels as well.
Wow.
Through December, January.
So that's summertime. So it's perfect to look out for that here. Raglan Fish is always very, very busy. So what would you say is the best time or day to visit?
So from Monday.
Monday
morning. Yeah. After the busy weekend. So
after
Monday morning is always the best.
Oh, perfect. Yeah. Okay. For those who are watching at home, who want to make their own fish and chips at home, what would be your top tip to make or recreate fish and chips at home?
Or maybe just order. Just scan and order and pick it up.
Raglan Fish actually have an app that you can order from. Could you tell a bit more about that?
Okay, so QR code,
yeah,
you have to scan. Mm-hmm. And then when you scan it, it's ready. Just click whatever you want to order.
Yeah.
And then pay and then just come and pick it up. You can choose what time you want to pick up. And then, yeah, just everything is ready and just enjoy.
That is amazing. That's so convenient too.
Yeah.
Thank you.
We also have an option for hand cut chips as well.
Hand cut chips?
Which is potato to the deep fry. It's mixed. Some people like it, some people don't.
Really? A drink you'd recommend that would pair well when ordering fish and chips?
Alright, for summertime, let's go for the fresh juice.
Yeah. So what I heard is Raglan Fish actually serve fresh juice during that time. So like orange juice?
We have orange juice, yeah. Pear juice.
Pear juice?
Yeah, and apple.
Apple, yeah, okay, that'd be like perfect.
We have a small orchard which we have pears, oranges, and lemons.
Really? Connected to Raglan. That's awesome.
We support a potato grower.
That's so awesome. Okay, while we're here at Raglan Fish, what is something we'd recommend to do in Raglan Town? Because it's a beautiful town. Yeah.
All right, first and foremost, go to the Raglan Fish. After a meal, then go for the charter boat.
Like, charter boat?
Yeah, just for the like an hour or so.
Amazing. I'll show you guys later. I'll take a video.
What did you, when you first arrived in Raglan, you have a must?
Oh yeah, true.
In the
Raglan,
it's all about hiking and surfing.
Yeah,
Kariwi Mountain and then surfing.
So. Perfect. And I'm so glad you mentioned Kariwi Mountain because that's actually my favorite hike that I've done so far. It's just a beautiful view. Like you said, surfing. Yeah. So Raglan's very much a beach town. So beautiful beaches. And when you hike Mount Kariwi from the top, it's the beautiful, beautiful beach view. So yeah.
See Mount Taranaki.
I did not know that. Where we can follow you? Where we can follow Raglan Fish?
Facebook.
Okay.
Facebook, yeah.
Facebook's the best, guys. I will link that in this video. And yeah, definitely a must visit. And thank you so much for interviewing.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us.
Oh, cool. Raglan Fish actually gave a free fish and chips meal, and they're very, what is it? Oh yeah, they're awesome white bait fritters that they were talking about in the interview, which I'm so excited to try and share with everyone. It's so hard driving right now and just smelling the goodness of the crispy fish and the they even made kumara chips, which is amazing. For those of you who haven't tried kumara chips, they are so good, especially when they are fried perfectly, which these ones absolutely look like they're fried perfectly. And yeah, so excited to try the white bait fritter as well. For some it's an acquired taste, but yeah, I just, from the smell, I just know it's going to be good. And the looks, like, the worst thing is sometimes when you have really soggy fish when you order fish and chips, but these ones look absolutely perfectly fried and they look so crispy and so yum. And yeah. Okay, hey everyone, just before I head off to the birthday, which we'll see these again, I just thought I'd describe it separately. So this is their classic white bait fritter, and this is a specialty dish that Raglan Fish do during white bait season, which is ending in 1 to 2 weeks. So it smells amazing, and it's served with lemon, as we can see. And you can see, I don't know if you can see the little white bait. Yeah, the white baits in this fritter, which is absolutely yum. For some it's an acquired taste, but this one looks so, so good. And yeah, just definitely a must visit in at Raglan Fish. This next dish is, as you can see, oh my gosh, it smells amazing. I am such a foodie. Yeah, so as you can see, one thing I would say is a really good fish and chips is you can tell by the batter. How well fried is the batter? And as you can see in this one, it is so crispy. I don't know if you can see. Oh my goodness, it looks so good to just like crunch into. And yeah, I can tell why it's very popular and busy. So yeah, usually it's served with really chunky fries, but this time they gave me some kumara fries, which are absolutely amazing, as you can see. And even their kumara fries aren't soggy. They look so crispy and so good. And you see they've got a lemon here as well. So it's usually served with lemon, salt and pepper, And for the sauces, there's a few different ones. Usually the classic ketchup, tomato sauce, mayo. Back then, before these sauces, it would be vinegar. But if not, more modernly, it is served with tartar sauce. So that's sort of like a mayonnaise-y egg sauce, very creamy. And so you can imagine like crunching into the crunchy fish, the crunchy chips with a spritz of lemon to offset or balance, and then you can dip it in some yummy ketchup or some tartar creamy sauce for that full rounded flavor in your mouth. Honestly, it's so good. You really can't come to New Zealand or go to Raglan, or it's such a beach. You cannot go to New Zealand and not try fish and chips, honestly. Find the best one in your area, and Waikato, I definitely recommend Raglan Fish. Plus, when you go to Raglan, since it's a beach town, a really beautiful town, very sustainable town, there's so much to do and see. Like we talked about in the interview, you can go surfing, you can do a nice hikoi, a hike, Mount Karioi, one of my favorites. You can visit their shops. It's all very sustainable and all very nice small town feel. So definitely a must visit. And if it's Tauranga, where I grew up in Greatan Tauranga, they definitely have an awesome, awesome fish and chips shop at the wharf as well. So yeah, I'd highly recommend that as well. But yeah, thanks so much to Raglan Fish. Guys, this looks so amazing. Definitely try out fish and chips when you're here in New Zealand.
Okay,
that's kumara chips.
Yay!